Google, tweet, and DM. What these three words have in common is they all derive from the internet, but have gone on to become verbs we might use every day. I binged that yesterday, or remind me to bing it when we get home, never really caught on. And that tells you everything you need to know about the success of Microsoft's flagship search engine. But in the eyes of many, Bing is more than just a second-rate alternative to Google. Let's delve into what happened to the search engine and whether Bing can ever recover from its current position. Here's how it happened. Bing's predecessor was MSN Search, which first launched in 1998 using results from internet service provider Inktomi and then AltaVista, the most popular search engine of the late 90s. Microsoft invested in its own web crawler bot in 2004 to index its own pages and give MSN Search its own results, hoping to overtake market leaders Google and Yahoo. Although the results provided by MSN weren't considered the most accurate, Microsoft's cause was helped by the prevalence of their web browser, Internet Explorer, which overtook Netscape as the world's most popular browser in 1998, peaking at 96% market share in 2004. Unsurprisingly, Explorer's default search option was through MSN, but the head start was short-lived as the launches of Mozilla Firefox in 2002 and Apple's Safari in 2003 began eating into Microsoft's market share. With the MSN brand struggling, the engine was completely revamped in 2006 as Windows Live Search, offering tabs with news, images, music, and even its own encyclopedia, Microsoft Encarta. But while Live Search's makeover did see several years of growth, there was simply no stopping the rise of Google, which broke through the 50% barrier of global market share in 2007. Coupled with the release of the Google Chrome web browser in 2008, Microsoft was forced to completely rethink its plan of attack, and the following year released Bing, replacing Live Search. The $100 million advertising campaign described the new service as a decision engine, and focused on some of Bing's innovative features, like the left-hand navigation bar offering related search results, and the ability to preview a web page by hovering the cursor over the respective link. At the same time, Microsoft also entered into a 10-year partnership with Yahoo, whereby Yahoo's search engine would be powered by Bing, and Yahoo would manage the marketing team that ran ads on Bing's results. Although Bing did reach a 10% market share within a couple of years, unfortunately that would prove to be the height of its success. Chrome had become the world's number one browser by 2012, and the increasing popularity of the iPhone and iPad ranges meant Safari was gaining ground too. Maybe one of Bing's biggest problems was the rise of smartphones, and the fact that neither iOS nor Android devices supported Internet Explorer, robbing Bing of its native browser from inside consumers' pockets. Microsoft continued with its aggressive marketing push, agreeing a deal for the website to appear in 2012's The Amazing Spider-Man. However, by the time the sequel was released 2 years later, Peter Parker had already changed his mind and resorted to Google for his next search, much to the amusement of Marvel fans. To rub salt in the wound, Microsoft has even been accused of using data from Google searches on Internet Explorer to copy results and replicate them in Bing, not the type of publicity that the search engine needed. So where does this leave Bing today? Well, the best estimates believe Bing's worldwide market share to reside somewhere around 3%, a long way behind Google's 91, but still ahead of the rest of the chasing pack. There's not much that totally distinguishes Bing from its rivals, like DuckDuckGo's enhanced privacy or Ecosia's tree-planting mission, but it can offer the most seamless integration into Microsoft Office 365, unrivaled compatibility with your Xbox, and unlike Google, no pesky captures to prove your status as a human. Bing has undergone several rebrands down the years, with 2020's facelift opting not to feature the latest Bing logo on the homepage at all, instead using the Microsoft one. Even Google is only estimated to have indexed around 5% of the internet's total content, with the other 95%, known as the deep web, hidden behind HTTP forms, passwords, or paywalls, meaning they can't appear in search results. With that being true, maybe you're just better off trying out a range of search engines and seeing which you prefer. There's a running joke amongst software engineers that Bing's name stands for Bing is not Google, which could just be its biggest selling point. And that's how it happened. Thanks for watching.